I'm Owen Bigland. This is the Inside Edge video blog. Let's do a quick video here on the current situation with the tenancy laws in the Lower Mainland. Now, as you guys know, I won't get into all the details with it, but I've done so many blogs on selling tenanted properties and why I, at all costs, try and get my seller to sell the home vacant, get the tenant out. I've talked about it in my book. It's the single biggest mistake that sellers make is selling a property with your tenant still in there. You know, when someone calls me and says, Owen, I want to sell a property, sell my condo or sell my home with tenants in it, you know, I will give them the pros and cons as a good realtor. I have to give my client the pros and cons to what they want to do. Mr. Seller, if you want to sell it with your tenant, the only advantage is that you don't lose any rent. If you're paying $2,200 a month, you're going to still continue to pay that $2,200, get that $2,200 a month. That's the only advantage. The disadvantage is that you're probably going to leave tens of thousands of dollars on the in the selling price for the simple reason that you're limiting your buyer pool here a great deal. Most investor clients do not want to assume tenants. They want to get their own tenant in there, especially if the tenant's been in there 2 or 3 years and is paying way below market rent. It's of no interest to the investor client or investor buyer. And principal residence buyers, if it's on a fixed term lease, they can't get the tenant out until the lease ends, the fixed term. Or if it's on month to month, they have to give at least 2 clear months notice. So downtown, if you're looking at condos, probably half the buyers are going to be investors. You're shrinking your buyer pool a great deal there. Not to mention the fact that tenanted properties generally don't show very well. I get the odd one that I've seen that's tenanted that looks good. Most of them are not great as far as the presentation goes. And it's difficult to show. You've got restrictions on open houses. You've got to get the permission of the tenant to show it. You're greatly handicapped and leaving tens of thousands of dollars on the table trying to sell a tenanted property, all for trying to just keep or continue to collect that $2,100 a month rent. It's penny wise, pound foolish, bottom line. And you know, I will do everything I can. My job as a listing realtor is to get my clients the maximum selling price, the maximum net selling price. To do that, it's much better to get the tenant out. Either wait until the tenant gives notice and moves out, and then we'll list it vacant. Or if you want to sell it now, we can use something called a mutual agreement to end tenancy. You're going to have to compensate your tenant a couple of months' rent. But everybody wins. The tenant feels good about it. He's getting a couple of months rent. He'll move out on a set date. It's now vacant. We can clean the property up. We can show it, run open houses. And we are exposed now to the complete full buyer pool. Principal residence buyers, as well as investors who are going to buy it and put their own tenant in it. Now, as of March 30th, though, the NDP came down with the COVID-19 lockdown here, that even if a tenant is on a month-to-month tenancy and someone wants to buy the condo to move into, that two-month rule is gone. They've terminated that temporarily until further notice. So in other words, you know, you cannot move into a tenanted property, whether it's fixed term or month-to-month, even with the 2 months notice, and you cannot currently evict a tenant. So I still see some condos, not a lot. A lot of them have been dropping off the market here, but there are still condos and homes on the market right now, townhomes, detached and condos, that are tenant listed as tenant occupied on the MLS. Now, Mr. Seller, if that is you, get that home or that condo off the market. You are leaving a tremendous amount of money on the table. Well, first off, the activity levels are down 80 to 90%. For right now. I think they're going to pick up starting in May, but you should at least wait until the state of emergency has been lifted, and they just extended it here at least until early May. So that's your first problem. The second problem is now if you've got a tenant in there, now you are really handicapping yourself there. You know, an investor, again, as I said, do not want to assume tenants, and they definitely don't want to assume tenants in this current environment where a lot of the tenancy laws have been changed. You can't evict a tenant. You can't give 2 months clear months notice on a month to month. You've got to be crazy right now to buy a condo or any house and assume a tenant. Not, you do not want to be doing that on the buying side. So Mr. Seller, you do not want to, definitely do not want to be selling with your tenant on there. So this is just another nail in the coffin on the biggest mistake people make in trying to sell tenanted properties. Until further notice, at least until the NDP lifts this restriction on the 2-month rule to get to move into a unit, I would take your tenanted property off the market. You are leaving, you're always leaving tens of thousands of dollars on the table. Now you're really restricting yourself in the fact that even if someone wanted to move into it as a principal residence, which makes up the majority of the buyers, they can't. They would have to buy it and assume your tenant until they remove that curfew and allow a 2-month notice rule to come in to move in. So doesn't make any sense to be listing tenant properties, yet I still see some on there. I just took a quick look at some condos downtown. I spotted right off the bat about 10 that are listed as tenant occupied. If that's you, Mr. Seller, take that off the market. You're leaving a lot of money on the market. Wait until the state of emergency is lifted. Wait until the NDP puts back that 2-month notice rule, clear month's notice, for a principal residence owner to move in. You at least need to wait for that. But again, I would not be selling a tenanted property. You are leaving so much money on the table. You really are. It still is the biggest mistake people make. You know, every now and again, I will sell a tenanted property. For whatever reason, you know, they want to leave the tenant in there. And in some cases, hey, the tenant's taking good care of the place. He's very cooperative. It shows well. Okay. But for 90% of the cases, you would be far better off getting a mutual agreement to end tenancy, pay the tenant a couple of months' rent, clean the unit up, run open houses, no restriction on showings. Investor buyers or principal buyers can buy it with quick closing if you want. No restrictions. And that's the final thing I'll just leave you here. These tenanted properties, with what's going on with the current lockdown, the COVID-19, you know, what is listed out there right now, most realtors, listing realtors, are having the buyers and their realtors sign waivers indemnifying them and their brokerage from any hazards that might be there if they were to catch COVID-19. Now, this brings up a whole can of worms. If you're showing a property that is tenanted and you're having buyers come in and out of that unit, I would consult a lawyer, at the very least, consult your managing broker on the implications here. Serious, serious legal ramifications with something like this, of showing a property with a tenant living in there still and people coming and going. I would just take it off the market until at least the state of emergency and some of the social distancing has been relaxed. And at the very least, at least when, until a buyer who wants to move into it can do so with 2 clear months, which they can't do right now. I'm Owen Bigland. As always, I'll see you next week.